A neo-Nazi who we've covered in the past is back, okay? Jon Minadeo Jr. There he is, this time in Poland. I want to just take the video here because these are US servicemen. I believe a supervisor is likely among them, and that perhaps is a good thing, as someone reminded me earlier, because this could have been a lot worse. Let's listen.
You guys Americans? You guys Americans? Are you guys here to spread sodomy or what? Isn't that what America's number one export is? What is it? Is it George Floyd culture? Is it sodomy? What do you guys think about, what do you guys think about your health secretary being a Hey guys, what do you guys think about your health secretary being a Nothing? What do you guys think about defending a country that has, there's no meaning to be a citizen? Like any Mexican crossing the border is literally one of you. What do you guys think? Are you guys here to spread the anal sex to Poland? What? Isn't that what you guys learn in your training? You guys literally have a transsexuals that wear dresses that are your superiors. Have you guys heard of Kay Griggs? She did an interview exposing it. The higher up levels of the military are all sodomites.
Everything he spews there, I'm not a psychologist, I have no degree, but I have suspicion that everything he targets as something he hates, he desires. I actually do believe that, Mayor. Every filthy thing he puts that label on, okay? I think adults should be able to do whatever they want. I believe he desires. What do you think, Mayor?
Yeah, I don't think you're far off. I think this is some serious projection happening right here. To speak of a country who is, you know, we are a diverse nation. Our nation is not based on a single race. The strength of America is immigration. And for him to talk about Mexican come across the border, you know, this is a ploy. What did strike me as interesting was US military personnel walking around in uniform in public. When I was in the Marine Corps, when we were going across seas, my first job was the Marine Corps. I would never have put on my, and we were, I was in a lot calmer time. I would have never worn my uniform from America, even on a plane directly to a military base because of the threat to you and yourself. So I find it interesting, unless they were on a mission in a mall, but I don't see military. So I'm that's interesting to me that you would be in camouflage off duty station like that. So I'm a little nervous about that. I think what happens though is we saw America, and I'm not a patriot in the sense that I swear allegiance to a flag. I swear allegiance to justice, and I do. There are beautiful things about America, and there's also horrible things. But I do think it's something that should be said about whoever is the officer that trained these gentlemen. The way that they just laughed and kept walking speaks extremely highly of their patience, because I don't know at their age or now if I have patience for someone stalking me like that. And he got extremely close to one of those soldiers, so much so that I could see his rank and also his unit that he was a part of. And I think that to me would have been enough to turn around and warn you very harshly to back up. So yeah. I applaud these brothers for keep walking, because it wasn't going to get them to react.
Like a grown man warning is really what you're talking about. He needed a little grown man warning. So he said everything he said. He invaded personal space, and then he did a zero in and target his hate towards the black soldier. Listen.
Keep Poland white, okay? Stay away from those white women. Hey, stay away from those white women. Because miscegenation used to be a crime in your country. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? You guys here to spread some homo worship and you get called out on it? Show us what a tough guy you are. You got an AR-15?
Woo!
Yeah. Yeah, you're in a white country now. There's no, we don't worship Mexicans.
Now, most of us people of color know you can't even walk through the mall without mall security harassing you from the moment you cross the threshold. I wonder, is there no mall security in Poland? It doesn't exist, Mayor. There's no one there. Let's tell you a little bit about this, because I agree. He came very close to getting something here, okay? And them showing him the American soldier way. Okay, US Army spokesman recently commended the group of young American soldiers for exercising restraint while they were verbally harassed by a racist neo-Nazi in the mall in Poland. In a statement to the Daily Mail on Friday, the US Army spokesman praised their response. The US Army expects all soldiers to abide by the Army values on duty and off. We commend all soldiers who demonstrate discipline and restraint when confronted by provocative behavior. Now, the video of the incident went viral this past week, and notorious neo-Nazi and racist Jon Minadeo Jr. has been accused of harassing these young men. Minadeo Jr., San Francisco Bay Area neo-Nazi, founded the extremist group Goyim Defense League, post racially motivated content on Gab, the far right wing social media site. While it remains unclear if Minadeo is behind this newest video of the soldiers, after going viral on social media, many people, including YouTuber Jameson's Travels, accused Jon Minadeo Jr. of being the man behind the camera. And after the accusations were thrown his way, Minadeo shared a link to the video on his Gab account. Instead of denying he was the one behind the vile abuse being dished out in the Polish shopping mall, he encouraged his fan base to wreck the YouTuber's comments. He wrote, "Boomer alert, wreck and gas comments, let's go." And he dropped the F-bomb there. Months ago, Polish authorities arrested 39-year-old Minadeo Jr. after he published this photo on Gab taken outside of Auschwitz. Minadeo was also wearing a swastika necklace besides posing with this vulgar banner that taunted Jewish leaders. In Minadeo's horrific stunt here, he held up the sign reading Greenblatt sucks 6 million. Both signs in the picture refer to Anti-Defamation League CEO Jonathan Greenblatt, who has been leading campaigns against anti-Semitism in the US. Another incident that Minadeo Jr. had earlier posted shows him berating this South Asian man near the Atrium Reduta shopping center in Warsaw for more than 4 minutes. Just mind his business, not gonna leave this man alone either. He accuses the man of effing up Europe, calls him a parasite, tells him that he should leave my country. This is my country. Minadeo lies. I'm European, why are you coming to the white man's land? You're genociding our race, you're an invader, go home invader. We don't want you in Europe, Poland for Polish only. Mayor, this kind of globe trotting, hey, it really is a full-time job. And I do wonder, I'm a mother, I work, I have upkeep, I need to rest. I wonder about the funding. This is a wealthy racist man's sport, no?
Yeah, and being a white nationalist neo-Nazi is also a way to become wealthy. I.e. Nick Fuentes and others, the Proud Boys and so many others have made, let me not exclude the past president, Donald Trump, have made so much money by presenting these ideas to the world on a global scale. We see so many folk that are YouTube famous, that are internet famous because of their very silly views, i.e. Tucker Carlson as well. Here's what I would say. There's gonna come a day where reckoning will happen for Mr. Minadeo. And I promise you, it's not gonna be pretty, because what happens is everybody is not bathed in this passivity. There will be reckoning. What's funny to me though is these American soldiers are probably a part of the brigade that sent to Poland for the enhanced protection army brigade, which is there to protect Poland from aggression from Russia. And I think it's so funny to me that you walk around free is free, because of, in part because of these brothers, these military American military soldiers who you are simply harassing just because you are trying to get clicks and views. Clicks and views. And I don't know if you believe it or not, but I would say one thing, and that one thing is it's absolutely disgusting and it should be criminal.
Wow. And like you said, probably getting rich off of it. I was once told, I think it was my grandmother, find your passion, pursue it, and you'll never work another day in your life. And I, unfortunately, grandma, the racists know that too. These white nationalists know that too.